Ooh, what is up everybody? Welcome to Shield Outdoors. If you're new to the channel, my name is Brad. We do all kinds of hunting and fishing videos. And here recently, I've wanted to start showing my collection and showing some guns and doing reviews. So every weekend I'm gonna do a gun review. Last week I did a Ruger Precision Rifle 308. I also had a ton of hunting footage that I was able to throw into that one. Today though, I'm gonna do one of my collector firearms. I'm not much of a collector. I own a lot of guns, but I use a lot of them. This gun doesn't get used. We're gonna talk about it. But first, if you would be so kind as to subscribe, that would really help me out. I'm not gonna be able to monetize these videos. Anything about guns and accessories really does not get monetized, or it gets heavily limited, so I can't make money on this video. But I can still grow, I can still get new subscribers like you if you're not already subscribed. So that would really, really, really be appreciated if you subscribe. If you have Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter, you can go check out Shield Outdoors over there. We post all kinds of our daily stuff, like different things that we're doing, fishing trips, whatever, and a little bit of extra giblets. Plus, we have giveaways all the time. I actually have a giveaway going on right now. It's for a bag of fishing lures and a hat. It's like 3 or 4 videos back. It'll end this week, but I have giveaways all the time. So let's talk about the M1 Garand. Oh, I've been killing the chipmunks with a BB gun, and one just popped out 5 feet away. Really, bro? You lucky I don't have any ammo with me. First off, let me say, I am not an expert in these firearms, and I'm not an expert in discussing these firearms or pronunciation of parts or anything like that. So if you don't like anything I say, just drop it in the comments below. Correct me, help me, teach me. I'm okay with that, I'm open to learning. So if I say anything that you're like, dude, that is not right, or if I say anything that you're like, dude, that is not what that's called, just comment below, and we'll talk about this after this plane goes by. So this is an M1 Garand. It's in 30-06 caliber, and it is a H&R. It says it right here on the receiver. Now, I haven't done too much homework on this gun just because I love the gun the way it is. I know the history of these rifles. I know the history behind how significant they were for the United States. I think it was General Patton. Was it General Patton said that it was the greatest weapon ever devised? So I have not done too much research. However, I do want to know about it. So if you are an M1 Garand guy, I'm going to give you enough information today that hopefully you can help me figure out this rifle. If I say anything that you know is wrong, just correct me. It does say H&R Arms on the top. The serial number is 5,600,000. Now, I believe that means that it was made in 1955, or assembled at least in 1955. I'm not 100% sure on that, so if you have a correction on that, let me know. But the bolt, the number on the bolt is D282, and then a bunch of numbers, B4A. So the bolt has a different number than the receiver, and as I understand, or at least from my limited research, that just means that when these came out of the military, they got reassembled and tested, especially by the civilian marksmanship program. They reassembled these to make sure that they were safe to use and safe for civilians. So I have 2 different serial numbers. As I understand, that's normal with rifles out of the CMP program, but any discrepancies, comment below. Now, there's a couple of different stamps on this. The first stamp is right here, right there. There is a P. It's a capital P with a circle around it. I have no idea what that means. If you know what that means, let me know. Also, there is a stamp on the side right here. There's a stamp right there, and it's a square with an American Eagle and 3 stars above it. There's not many markings on this thing. The stock is in excellent shape. I took this to a guy one time and said, hey, tell me about it. What do you know about it? And he said, all I know is this thing is in great shape. However, like I said, the CMP reassembled these, sometimes with different parts, mismatched parts, to make them safe. So I guess we'll just talk about the CMP real quick in case you don't know what it is. The Civilian Marksmanship Program was actually started like back in like 1906, I think, by Teddy Roosevelt. And the reason they started a civilian marksmanship program was to teach people how to shoot and to up the accuracy and the marksmanship of United States civilians and military members. And then all the way up in 1996, it got kind of reorganized, but it is a federally funded program, and it's kind of a way for them to get rifles out to the public, get rid of old stock, teach people how to shoot. Plus, there's tons of youth programs. So if you have a youth who you want to learn how to shoot, the CMP program is for you. Look it up. That's all we'll kind of go into for now, except for the CMP, Civilian Marksmanship Program, gets funded by the government, and the government provides these rifles to provide to the program. I live really close to an airport, so I'm sorry. Okay, so, as I said, this is chambered in 30-06. Although you cannot shoot standard modern 30-06 ammunition through here. It's not safe, it's not recommended. Some of the new 30-06 is hot stuff, and it will have a much higher chamber pressure, or CUP, than this is rated for. What you have to shoot with this is M2 ball ammo, of which I actually have, I had an opportunity to buy a 500 round like metal case. I got a great deal on it. It's probably worth $400 or $500, but I have an entire case of M2 ball ammo, and that is specifically, it's still 30-06 caliber and dimensions and all that, but the chamber pressure should be much lower. I have shot this gun. I've taken this out to 300 yards. It does have an adjustable rear sight, and I've shot it out to 300 yards, and it is so ridiculously accurate. Now, if you didn't know about these guns, some of them, people put 308 barrels on, and sometimes they put a national match barrel in 308 on them, and they are, I mean, it's just a modernized, super, super accurate rifle, and people shoot these in competitions all the time. If you're an M1 Grand guy, you know. If you are an M1 Grand guy, you know these are not dead. These rifles are very alive. There's several competitions with them every year. People use them across the world. The H&Rs are usually very, very, very nice rifles. And every time I've ever seen one in a shop, these things are anywhere from $1,500 to $3,000. I paid not that much. These are legal to hunt with. You can hunt with this in most states that allow high-powered rifles. You could take this out and deer hunt with it. There's videos on the interwebs of people deer hunting with it, coyote hunting with it. Now people ask me, would you ever take this hunting? Would you ever do this or that with it? Would you ever take it to a competition? I don't see myself competition shooting. I have been so busy with YouTube and eBay and other things, remodeling my house. I don't see myself shooting competitively. Plus, that's a whole nother level. The people who shoot these competitively, if y'all are watching this, y'all are incredible. It's incredible what people can take this instrument and do. It's crazy the accuracy they can get and the distance they can get. That's not me. I might shoot a 300 yard target and get a 2 or 3 inch group and I'm real happy. Those dudes are getting like a couple inch group at 1,000 yards. There's people shooting paper plates at 1,000 yards with open sights. That is not me. They're just a piece of history. They're crazy. It's crazy to think that this is gonna be 100 years old soon. It's 2021. In 10 years, 10, 15 years, some of these are gonna be 100 years old. Isn't that crazy? This video is gonna be short and sweet. I actually worked the next 2 days, so I had to make this video quick. I also have to go work out still today, and I still need to mow. But thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for checking out our videos, checking out the guns. We're gonna do more videos. My other videos, I'm gonna have more kill footage of, and some of the videos, I'm gonna actually get some shooting in and maybe show the operations of the rifle, but you guys know the M1 Grand. Everybody knows the 11-year-olds know the M1 Grand because it's on every video game that has ever been made of World War II. So thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much. Consider subscribing. Stick around for us. Check out Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter. And tell me about your M1 Grand. If you have one, tell me about it. And anything you know about this one, let me know. Let me know about this P right here. And let me know about the little square with the eagle and the stars on the left side. Other than that, catch you on the next one. Peace. Oh, that feels so good. Oh, it feels so good.